In this video, you will learn the basics of using the WordPress editor to create and edit content. Remember, every piece of content is added as a block, making it super flexible to design and structure content. A block is like a building piece you use to create content on your website. Think of it like Lego. Each block does something different, and you stack them together to build a web page. And one of the benefits is that you can exactly see what your content looks like as you build it. For example, a paragraph block lets you write text, an image block lets you add a photo, a video block lets you embed a video, and a buttons block adds a clickable button, and so the list goes on. To get started, click the plus icon in the top left corner to add a new block. You will see a list of block types, like paragraph, image, heading, button, etc. And then you can click the one you want to add. In this case, the heading block. You can also use a shortcut by typing /, and the block's name, for example, image. Then I will add an image that I've already uploaded to my media library. And once added, I will hit enter, and then you will notice that the paragraph block appears. The paragraph block is the default text block, so you don't need to add it intentionally. And when you are ready, you can add your own text. There are over 100 blocks you could add, so don't worry about learning them all. We're just showing you a few popular ones. You can use the search function to find what you need. First up, let's search for the quote block, and then add our quote, as well as a citation. You will notice there are various categories of blocks. Let's add one of the media blocks, namely a cover block, that allows you to overlay text on an image or video. Once added, you will notice WordPress automatically adds an overlay color, and then you can add the text, increase the size, and even add some horizontal and vertical space or padding around the content. So as you can see, we can build our entire website using blocks. When you select and edit a block, its toolbar appears automatically, with formatting buttons that change based on the block's purpose. You can, for example, change the alignment of the text, as well as other formatting options. You even have the option to transform or change a block to a similar block type. So you may decide to change this heading block to a paragraph, a list, or even a quote. When you click on the three vertical dots of the toolbar, you have a few other options. You can copy and cut the block, duplicate the block, and if you want to add content before the block, you can select Add Before and Add After if you want to add content below the block. And then right at the bottom, you have the option to delete the block. Next, when you open the sidebar settings of the block top right, you can style the block further. Below color, you can change the text color or the background color. You can also modify the typography, such as the font size, the appearance, and even the letter case. When you click the three vertical dots next to typography, you have even more options to choose from. And below dimensions, you will be able to add or remove padding and margin to the block. So when you select a block, you will notice that the block toolbar and the sidebar settings relate to that specific block. And for the image block, you will notice you have settings as well as styles. Next, let's discuss moving or repositioning a block. When you select a block, you can use the little arrows or movers in the block toolbar to move the block to a new place on your page or post. You can also drag blocks into place using the list view. To open the list view, click the three horizontal lines in the top left corner. This view provides an organized outline of all your blocks and any nested blocks. When you're ready, select a block and then drag and drop it to a new position to relocate it. If you want to keep blocks together, highlight multiple blocks and group them using the block toolbar. You can group blocks together in a regular group or as a row, stack, or grid. The group block lets you keep several blocks together, so you can move and manage them as one. I will go ahead and group these blocks together in a regular group block. Now we can open up our sidebar settings and style our group as one. In this example, I will change the background color of the group, add some horizontal padding, add a 5-pixel border, and then you can use the block toolbar to change the alignment to, for example, full width or wide width. You can also use the columns block to lay out content side by side. When you insert a columns block, you can choose your preferred layout. Let's select two equal columns. To select the main columns block, click on the left of the block toolbar, and then we can change the alignment to wide width, and then start adding content into our first column. Then I will open up my list view as it helps me to navigate all the content on my page. Next, I will select my first column, click the three vertical dots, and select duplicate to save time by reusing the same layout and settings. Then I will select the main columns block again and open my sidebar settings top right. And below settings, you will be able to increase or decrease the amount of columns. And when you select styles, you can customize your columns block as you please. One thing to highlight is that below block spacing, you can add or remove space between columns. Another amazing feature to highlight is patterns. They save you time and basically do all the work for you. Patterns are pre-designed block layouts that you can easily customize with your own content. To add a pattern, click on the plus icon top left and then select the Patterns tab. Then you can browse the available categories. You can, for example, find layouts for your About page, your Contact page, and more. Then you can scroll through all the available options. When you find a pattern you like, you can click on it to insert it into your page or post. And then you can customize the pattern to meet your needs. One more thing I wanted to mention is if you make a mistake, don't be concerned. You can always use the undo and redo button top left. If you have any queries, click the question mark icon top right to learn more about any aspect of blocks and editing in WordPress. That's it. With blocks, patterns, and layout tools, the WordPress editor helps you to build and manage your content.